God is good. Pleasant good morning to you. He ran after his wife. I told a man once that if my wife threatens to leave me, I will go after her and do everything necessary to get her back, but not violence, not violence. Some reasons why I will go after my wife. One, I do not want another wife. Two, it is too difficult to get another wife like my wife. Then, I am afraid that whosoever gets my wife, if she leaves me, would have gotten somebody who I invested so much in and trained so well. That would be a terrible loss to me. That is how serious I am about keeping my wife. The other thing is that a good husband-wife relationship is key or pivotal to family, extended family, and to my sanity and grandchildren, etc. A good husband-wife relationship is pivotal to that. Now, there's a situation here in 2 Samuel chapter 3 and verse 12 that you must go and read it, because some of you don't know it is in the Bible. In 2 Samuel chapter 3 and verse 12, it says, "And Abner sent messengers to David on his behalf, saying, Whose is the land? Saying also, Make thy league with me, and behold, my hand shall be with thee to bring about all Israel unto thee. And he said, David answering now, Well, I will make a league with thee, but one thing I require of thee, that is, thou shalt not see my face, except thou first bring Michal, Saul's daughter, when thou comest to see my face." And David sent messengers to Ish-bosheth, Saul's son, saying, "Deliver me my wife Michal, which I espoused to me for 100 foreskin of the Philistines." Listen to verse 15. "And Ish-bosheth sent and took her from her husband, even from Phaltiel, the son of Laish. And her husband," that is Phaltiel, "went with her along, weeping behind her to Bahurim. Then Abner said unto him, Go, return. And he returned." Now there's a lot packed in this story, but let me explain something that some of you don't know. Michal was David's wife, Saul's daughter, and David's dowry or bride price was not 100 foreskin of the Philistines. Saul tried to endanger David's life. David got 200 foreskin of the Philistines and came and threw them at Saul and said, "Listen." And Saul had no choice but to deliver Michal to David as his wife. Now there's a battle going on between David and King Saul. Saul is trying to rebuke, and Saul is trying to kill David. So guess what? Guess what? In the interim, when that battle is going on, it seems as though, I didn't read that, but it seems as though Saul took back Michal. So Michal is not with David. So now Abner, the general for Saul, wants to make a league or truce or peace with David. David said, "Hold it right there, right there. The only way I will hold a truce is for you to give me back my rightful wife." And what's the guy name? He has a strange name. Let me check for his name here, right? Phaltiel, the son of Laish, who is now the second husband, he comes running behind, who is not his legal wife. And Abner the general said, "Go back, leave the man, let Michal go with her rightful husband." Now, two things as I close. If your wife are talking to men now, If your wife tried to leave you, do like me. Do everything to try to keep her. Listen, why? Because your wife is somebody valuable to you. In this case, Faltiel, he runs after his wife, but Dana, his wife, is somebody else's property, put it that way. He is trespassing. So those individuals who are listening to me, who trespassing with another man's wife, stop it, Dana, your wife, stop it. Get your own and give up on that individual like Faltiel had to do so that David could get back his rightful wife. God and Father, help somebody today to understand that if they're not married to a person, that's not their wife or their husband. That is something sinful they're doing, and they need to give up on that relationship and go according to your word. Help us who are married to love our wives unconditionally so that they will want to stay with us. Bless us throughout the day, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen. May God richly bless you.
There's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see it afar. For the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there.
In the sweet by and by,
in the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful